money's worth tonight on Saturday night. Closed captioning, guys, should be getting double pay. Why? This is very difficult to keep up with. You with your front chancery comments from earlier? Please.
You don't even know what a front chancery is, do you?
It was the old car that had the steering wheel on the right side and an 8-track, right? No.
When you call yourself an announcer.
I know what a front chancery is. It's a front face lock where you've got the arms tied up in there. Come on.
With the arms tied up in there. Yeah, there you go. You got it.
All right. Tell me what a front chancery is.
After the show, I don't want to do this myself.
Good point. But at least keep what rating we've got left.
But wait a minute. Of course, if I put you out, you'll go way up.
Well, if we put it on the air... Hugh Morris! Well, let's go down to the ring during the break. In the next commercial, we'll go there and work out.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, boy. Sorry. We'll edit that out later. Hugh Morris! What a big, powerful individual. And there's an interesting question. Hugh Morris, where does he fit in? Is he part of the new generation? Or is he part of the established stars in WCW? Morris is kind of a tweener. He's been around for a few years.
Well, he's been around, but again, this is going to tell everybody, you know, where these guys' heads are at. Are they thinking like, you know, a seasoned pro? Are they thinking of, you know, like they're a success? You've got to have confidence. You've got to say to yourself, hey, I don't need to be brought up the ladder. You know, I'm at the top. You've got to believe in yourself. And I think Russo's going to take advantage of the insecure guys, where Bischoff is going to have to deal with the basically hard to deal with pros.
So you don't envy either man in this upcoming battle. I don't either. Got tons of respect for both of them.
A star is a double-edged sword.
No, a star is a star, actually.
No, it's a double-edged sword. I mean, you need them. Otherwise, you have no show.
Right. Lateral press from Steve Armstrong on Hugh Morris.
So you've got to put up with the egos of the stars.
It's kind of like what they say about some other people. See, can't live with them, can't kill them.
Russo's trying to take shortcuts, and he already tried that once, and it didn't work.
Russo did?
Yeah, he wants to promote the guys who aren't stars because they're easy pickings and easy to deal with.
Yeah, but then again, we want to be here in 3 or 4 years, or 10 or 12 years. You got to pump the young guys up. You got to bring the new generation to the fore. That's what Vince Russo wants to do. And I think men like Hugh Morris are going to lead the way in World Championship Wrestling.
Look, wrestling's been around since the birth of man, thousands and thousands of years. Whoop, Armstrong slithered out of that one. But three things are definite that will go on forever, Scott.
Yes.
Death, taxes, and professional wrestling.
I don't disagree. Steve Armstrong disagreeing vehemently with the attack from Hugh Morris.
Well, Hugh Morris is built perfect for wrestling. I mean, he's got a low center of gravity, a thick midsection. You know, I'm not saying, I mean, he's not chubby. He's solid, but
absolutely.
You get your strength, you get your power from, you know, your midsection. And if you can use your weight and your balance, you know, like Hugh Morris does. Wait, Armstrong got a good one in.
Snuck a forearm inside, lateral pressing. No, Morris rolled a shoulder at two.
Hey, Morris back up quick. Armstrong should know better. I mean, gotta get it very aggressive, especially to a guy that, you know, outweighs you. And there you go. Start using the moves, but you can't pull him down.
The low center of gravity. No. Morris ducked out of the way. Opened up his hand and Armstrong
ducked out of the way. You're getting me confused.
Sorry about that.
How can you miss him with that shirt?
I'll be the first one to tell you I've got a huge crush on Mona. So I'm not comparing Mona to Hugh Morris, but Hugh Morris also. I said Mona earlier had strength and agility, power and agility. Hugh Morris has 10 times the strength and as much agility as Mona. He'll come off the top rope like a cruiserweight.
Yeah, and they're the same size.
Not hardly. He's three of her easily.
Tell you, he's got Armstrong in trouble, and he's...
Armstrong hung out to dry. Here comes Hugh Morris.
What is he doing?
Whoa!
Nailed him again. Armstrong, he's down.
The freight train. Steve Armstrong got a breath left in his body.
We're talking about the advantage of having the weight and being able to use it along with the ability to fly.
The no laughing matter. What impact? Wait a second. What in the world? He just Hugh Morris just pulled Armstrong on top.
Well, that wasn't very smart.
Well, he kicked out at least, if you want to call it that, and Ned covered him. Not a textbook cover, but Hugh Morris, that is a strange individual and dangerous. The power, the agility, and there's nothing between those ears. That's a dangerous,
well,
dangerous man.
There's something between those ears. Very thick skull.
A little Saturday night humiliation.
Let's go back and take a look, legend. This is our Castro Motor Oil replay of the week. Castro Motor Oil.
Hey, Hugh Morris hard. Just drives that head down hard right into Armstrong here. He just exploded across the ring, and Armstrong got the wind knocked out of him, never regained it, and watched the big man fly. Bischoff or Russo, whoever can manage this guy's a winner.
Motor oil that provides maximum protection. Castrol GTX. Drive hard. Three count.